Hello. In this video demo, I'll show you how to create an ETL function in Rust, compile it to WebAssembly, and run it in the WasmEdge sandbox. The ETL function will continuously receive transactions from the Ethereum blockchain nodes. It filters the transactions, converts ETH amounts to USDs according to the latest exchange rate, and then saves the simplified records into a relational database for easy analysis later. Now, let's look into the code for the ETL. First, we have a struct that models the database table schema that we want to save to. It contains the transaction parties and amounts in both ETH and USD based on the real-time exchange rate. Second, we have the transform function. It passes the input data from the blockchain node. The input data is in JSON format. The transform function filters the records it wants, does the ETH to USD price lookup and conversion, and then generates a SQL statement. Notice that the SQL statement would insert or update the transaction record depending on its confirmation status. Third, we'll connect the inbound and outbound of the ETL function as a service. The outbound is a database connection for the ETL output. The inbound here is the HTTP webhook. The data source sends the data to the webhook for ETL transformation. Of course, we can do a lot more than our HTTP webhook. For example, we can have Kafka connectors that receive messages from a Kafka queue. Now, let's compile the ETL function to WebAssembly, just to use the standard Rust cargo build command to do that. Then, you can start the ETL function using WasmEdge. Notice, there are two environmental variables here. The database URL is the backend cloud database the ETL should write into. Here we use the TiDB cloud instance. The price API key is the API key for the ETL to look up ETH to USD prices in real time from another web service. Once the ETL service starts, you can put its webhook into the Node API service provider. In this case, we use Block Native's mempool API to send Ethereum transactions to our webhook. I will not show it here. Now, I can show you a running log of the ETL function. It logs all the raw Ethereum transactions it receives from the node in JSON format. Going to the TiDB Cloud SQL console, we can see the records in the database table. You can filter, map, transform, record, and then analyze blockchain transactions based on your own logic in real time. Give it a try. Thanks.